piece of Seymour Avenue history now reduced to rubble. It took crews 2.5 hours to tear down two vacant houses, which sat in between a vacant lot and Ariel Castro's former home. Neighbors watched from their porches, many grateful to witness the demolition. Two abandoned homes so close to the House of Horrors, where Amanda Berry, Gina DeJesus, and Michelle Knight were held captive for more than 10 years.
Yeah, it's better empty than, you know, empty houses. I'm doing any good.
They were just abandoned there, so it feels good to see it all cleaned up, nice, and, you know, whatever they want to build is fine with me.
The Cuyahoga Land Bank gave the green light for the demolition, made possible by crews from Independence Excavating, which donated their services. Cuyahoga County Prosecutor Tim McGinty was also on site and says this is a tribute to the three women and to Cleveland police who never gave up looking.
So this is a great day. This is a great day when they tore Castro's house down. This is another great day here. This is symbolic. It's cathartic to the victims, to the community, to the families.
Within 90 days, Castro's home was torn down and he was sent to prison for the rest of his life without parole. As for what to do with the vacant lot, some would like to see a garden or park or even a shelter for battered women, for a community that is still healing and forever changing.
Now everybody keeps their eyes more open. Now we're wiser in the neighborhood.
Something that make them girls happy, like an environmental park or something.
In Cleveland, Jennifer Jordan, Fox 8 News.